In this video, I'll compare halogen headlights with LED headlights on my 2009 Honda Civic. I'll also let you know if this was a smart upgrade. Then I'll show you how to install these in your vehicle if you choose to do so. Let's get started. Let's get started by laying everything out. Looks like we have a warranty card. We have some gloves so you don't get oil on the bulbs, and then some mounting hardware. Now remove the LEDs from the protective case and lay them out on a nice clean cloth. You don't want oil or anything on that cloth. Make sure it's clean. You're gonna have two for the high beams and two for the low beams. So my next step is to remove the battery. You don't have to remove the battery as long as you don't have huge hands. I'm removing it to help me film. But you do have to remove this coolant reservoir bottle, and that just pulls up. Once everything's out of the way, you'll have a clear view of the bulbs you're gonna replace. The one closest to the fender is the low beam, and the one towards the middle of the car is the high beam. So next step is to pull the lights off. So if you look right here, there's a tab that you gotta push down. And then also here, there's a tab you have to push down to pull that out. So let's do that. Okay. And then there's that tab. That's how I did it. Okay, so that one's off. And I'll do this one. Same thing. Just kind of rock it back and forth. There it is. And then here's that tab. That's how that works. All right. Next thing we need to do is remove the light. So on these, you're just gonna grab the bottom of it, put your thumb right here, and twist towards you, or towards the middle of the car. It's gonna go a quarter turn. There, and you don't wanna touch the bulb on these or the LEDs. High beam, the same thing. We're gonna get it and we're gonna twist it that way. And then we're gonna rock it out. And there's the high beam. Looks like I had a high beam going out anyway. So I'm gonna put on the glove. That's gonna keep oil on my fingers from getting on the bulb. This one here is a 006. This is gonna be the low beam. And I'm gonna go ahead and replace that with the LED 006. And this one here is a 005. And I'll also replace that with one of these LEDs, which is a 005, which is the high beam. Okay, let's put this in the car. We're gonna put the 9006 for the low beams. Now, comparing these two, you see the tab on the top? That'll go up. And then we need to go at a slight angle here. So when you go in, you want to go in with the tab up and turned in slightly counterclockwise. And that's going to go at an angle as you put it in towards the fender. Then once you get it in carefully, be careful not to get any dirt on there. Use your other hand to kind of push it in and then push it clockwise. And you'll feel it seat. And then you're good. Now let's take that connector and let's carefully plug that in. As you put it in, kind of rock it a little bit just to make sure everything goes in, and you'll hear it click. And we're done with this portion. Now let's go ahead and do the other side, the high beam, the 9005. There's your tab. Your tab's going to go up, but yet it's going to go at an angle. As you can see, it fits right in there again. It's at a slight angle, and then we're going to push it with our other hand and turn it clockwise. And again, you'll feel it seat. Now let's take that connector. Plug it in, and you'll hear it click when it's all in. Perfect. We just got two LED lights in now. Now all we got to do is secure the little module here. I found if I just secure this on some existing wires that are already there, it would be out of the way. So when you're doing this, just make sure where you secure it isn't going to be hit by anything that's going to be filling in there, like the battery or the coolant bottle. Right where I put it is out of the way. Now let's reinstall our battery and our coolant reservoir bottle. Now we can compare the lights. There's the halogen and here's the LED lights. Now let's go ahead and install the other side. We're gonna need a jack because we need to jack up the front end a little bit because we're gonna go through the fender here. So it looks like somebody's been already in here because most of my clips are missing. But it does look like I do have one here. So I'm gonna remove that clip. And it looks like there's another one there. So you want to pull back that inner fender cover and then reach your hand up there and pull the connector off the light bulb. And then just reach your hand back up there and turn it so you can pull it out. And then get the LED light and just reinstall it just like you did the other side. Should push right back in there, and then once you get the tabs in, just turn it back clockwise and it should be situated. And then just make sure you hook up your connector to the new light just like you did before. Now the high beam you should be able to get from the top. Just repeat the procedure. Push the clip, pull the connector off, turn the light bulb, and remove it. Then replace it with the LED light, just as you did the other side. And then make sure you situate all the connectors so they're out of the way. So was the LED light upgrade worth it? Absolutely. I liked it so much that I bought another set for my other car. If you learned something in this video, give me a thumbs up and I'll see you in the next video.